Hi everyone. Today we are going to see the difference between time axis and space axis, which is very important to understand many concepts of electrical machines. Let's see. Let's take a machine. We're having here a rotor, which is wound with the field winding. Let's assume there is some stator. Now, if I cut this stator here, if you make a cut over here, and if you see, if you take this one as 0 degrees instant, and this as 90 degrees in space, again, this is 180 degrees in space, this is 270 degrees in space, and back 360 degrees in space or 0 degrees in space. Now, if this rotor is excited with a current, let's take a current magnitude. With respect to time is some constant. My current magnitude is constant at each and every instant of time. At this instant of time, something. At this instant, same. At each and every instant, it is same. Now, let's check the flux density at these points. Means we're checking now the flux density around the space. We'll take here, this is magnitude of flux density B with respect to x-axis is space angle. That is, here we'll take 0 degrees instant and next 90 degrees, like that. This is space angle. Okay, so this side throughout will see the space part, space angle. This side will see at different instants of time. Now, here at this instant, the flux density is maximum here, because pole is just over here, flux density is maximum over here, and the flux density will be zero at this instant, and here flux density is negative maximum because we have a south pole here. So if I plot that flux density shape, this is the flux density. Zero degrees, 90 degrees, 180 degrees, 270 degrees, 360 degrees. Now what if rotor rotates? If the rotor is rotating, see here, rotor has taken 90 degrees rotation. Now at 90 degrees in space, at 90 degrees in space, we have maximum flux density. At 0 degrees in space, we have 0, and so on at each and every instance. Now, if the magnitude of the current, now I reduce the magnitude of the current, I just reduce the magnitude of current, then what will happen to the flux density? As magnitude is reduced, flux density maximum value also reduced. As it is reduced further, this also gets reduced further. Similarly, there also. Now, if the current magnitude is negative all the time, this also changed its sign. Likewise. Now, if current flowing through this coil is sinusoidal, then what will happen? My rotor is not moving, but the current which is fed to this coil is changing with respect to time in this fashion. So at this instant of time, we have maximum current, and this is the flux density shape over this space. Now, as the magnitude reduces, magnitude of the current reduces, we have seen before, as the magnitude of current reduces, this maximum value keep reducing. You can see that here. As current magnitude is changing, its magnitude is increasing, like this. So this is what we'll call it as standing pulsating wave. Means if you see here, it gets pulsations. It's pulsating. It's not moving, but it is just pulsating, positive to negative, negative to positive. Hence it is called as standing pulsating wave. And this concept is very important to understand rotating magnetic field theory in case of AC, and there are many other concepts in electrical engineering machines. Thanks for watching. If you want us to discuss any topic in electrical engineering, please write to us through comment section below. And please subscribe to our channel for more updates. Thank you.